I'm Mandisa. Hey, everybody. Brought together a group of my friends today to talk all things singleness and relationships. It's about to get real. Welcome to What If We Were Real? I have gathered you here today. I've got the fellas on this side and the ladies on this side. I've got some married friends. I've got some single friends. And we really want to talk about what is on the mind of us as single ladies and single men that we can maybe glean some wisdom from these people here. So I'm going to ask everyone to introduce themselves. Tell us four things. Your name. If what you're wearing is actually something you would sleep in, because I asked everybody to wear their pajamas, and if not, what do you sleep in? The third thing I want to know is one word to describe your relationship status, and then lastly, what is one word that you would use to describe how you feel about your relationship status?
Curtis Zachary.
Also known as?
My friends call me CZ since I was a kid, married to an incredible woman. And
for how long?
12 years.
So good.
And the word I would use is overjoyed.
Wow.
Overjoyed. Straight
She's up. Gonna be very happy to hear that that's the word
I'm
that you
very
use.
Happy that she is the one. So cool.
That's great. So y'all, I brought together a group of good godly men sitting to my left and to my right. Mr. Cade.
Yeah, my name's Cade Thompson and I'm 19 years old, and this is actually what I sleep in.
Is it?
What?
You know you
lie. No, I'm being dead serious.
You sleeping in the shoes too, bro?
Okay, not the shoes.
Yeah. And the necklace?
Okay, let me take that back.
Let me change it. We'll be around men, bro.
You sleep on top of the covers in both shoes.
This is what I sleep in. Okay. The bottoms are what I sleep in.
Okay.
And there it is.
Okay, not the sweatshirt.
Not the sweatshirt. Okay. Not the chain, not the shoes. Yeah.
Got it. Right. Okay, you gotta dress it up a little
bit. You got socks on?
I do have socks.
You sleep in a sock suit?
I do. I actually do
Wow.
Kind of weird.
It's a little, it's not.
Blazing up.
I get really cold, so.
What? Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, that makes sense.
Okay, that makes sense.
So, yeah. I'm currently single, and I guess for this season, something that would describe my season of singleness is trusting and also devotion to the Lord.
So, love that.
Yeah.
You are 19 years old.
I am 19.
I'm going to get flooded with people saying, can I get his number?
Okay. He sleep in socks too.
All right, girls. You are how I'm ending my day. I started with the fellas today. I had some men and women a little bit before you, and now I'm ending in my comfort zone because I'm a girl's girl. Y'all know this about me. But I know you. My friends watching do not. So I'm going to start over here.
Hello. My name is Jamie Jim Goshen. Been friends with Disa for several years.
Because we're old.
I'm not old. Wiser.
Yes.
These are my PJ bottoms. The top wasn't quite appropriate. So
what's your top normally look like?
It's cute. It's like a little lower cut.
Your future husband's gonna love that.
She's wearing me right for the show. Yeah. But there it's, you know, same material, really comfy.
Yeah.
And then it's just like a little loungy thing. It's like a PJ lounge. So I'm wearing one of my t-shirts.
Yes, and tell them what it says.
It says worship in the waiting.
Come on.
I love to encourage men and women wherever you're at in life to make the best of the season you're in.
Amen.
And worship is such a powerful weapon. So
I love that. Marital status.
Single and ready to mingle.
Okay, and is that your one word to describe how you feel about your marital status?
One word would be, I'm so expectant.
Okay,
yeah, good answer. Very expectant for it.
All right, my name is Candace Watkins. I would wear this to bed, minus the sneakers and the hat. I would just have some pajama pants on of some sort. Usually a sweatshirt that I'll take off in the middle of the night because I'm hot.
Yeah, I was going to say, don't you get hot?
I just moved to a new house and I have not figured out the thermostat. It'll change on its own.
Oh, gosh.
And so I hate being cold when I go to bed. So
me
I'll
too.
Usually go with a sweatshirt and then take it off in the middle of the night.
Got it. Yeah. Okay. And your marital status and one more to describe how you feel.
I am single and I am hopeful.
That's so good.
Yeah.
So it's interesting hearing you talk about the whole temperature thing, because that's one of the things that I notice as a difference in men. And maybe it's because I travel on a tour bus with men. Men always want it to be like 50 degrees on the bus, and I always want it to be 75 degrees on the bus. Totally. Is that a generalization, or do you think that that is actually a difference in a man and a woman, is the whole temperature thing?
I think it definitely is.
You think so?
My fiance loves when the house is like 50 or 60, and I'm like, I could sleep in 85 degrees. Like,
yes!
It's
yes!
Oh, no, nah, yes. I'll take it at
60. It's so much better for your health, though, hot. To have it cold at night.
Oh, really? Yeah.
So much better for your health.
That's what the guys on my bus say. And I say, I don't care. I'm actually paying for the bus. So we're going to have the temperature that I want, which is maybe why I'm single. So that leads me to the question that I want to ask you. Why are you still single?
I won't compromise.
Good.
And I've met some great men, and either they think they're ready, but they're not, or they can't be vulnerable or connect in a deeper way. And, or I've got to pursue and they aren't stepping up in that. And I don't want to be the one to make it happen because I pursue you.
Why not?
It doesn't feel comfortable for me. I don't want my marriage to be like that.
Okay.
I think both people pursue each other.
Yeah.
But if I'm the one that has to bring up, what are we doing? Let's define this.
Yeah.
I have to bring up all these things.
Okay.
I don't want that to be the setting. I don't want that to define how our relationship goes.
Well, interesting, Elizabeth. I know some of your story with your boyfriend. Yeah. So when I hear I don't want to be the one to pursue, because I'll be honest, Candace, I don't either. And I know as a confident, outspoken CEO of my own making that men will be intimidated by many men will be intimidated, not all. And so I've actually been told maybe in the last month or so, I might actually have to be the one to make an initial move. And that feels so out of the box, uncomfortable for me. You have some experience with that.
Yeah, so with me and my boyfriend, I mean, things, I had to really realize that there's a reason why there was some timidness there for him. Mm-hmm. And that goes down to his story, you know, like, just like I've walked through things that have made me a little bit gun shy in regards to certain parts of my life, that was the case for him. Past relationships had made him a little bit more afraid of jumping into something too quickly.
Yeah.
You know, and for me, I'm coming in, you know, I had been single for 4 years. So I was like, when I see the thing that I, you know, I'm like, this could work. This could be great. You know, I was quick to kind of initiate that. But for him, and we had known each other for a year. We had toured together and we had lived some life together. So we were friends already.
Yeah.
But for him, it took him probably a good 2 months or so of just us knowing like we're interested in one another. Mm-hmm. But he was like, I'm afraid to mess this up. Like, I don't want to hurt you. And and it took a little bit on my end to say, hey, like, I'm a safe place. Like, I trust that the both of us can meet in the middle on this and be mature adults about this rather than, you know, for instance, him kind of viewing like his relationship when he was young, when he was 23, and being like, what if this happens again, you know? So even just knowing his story and being willing to enter in almost with the bravery, you know, like having to say, okay, I know that you're scared about this, but I trust that we're different people than who we were then.
Yeah, so good.
That is good.
I'm wondering how personality plays into this, because I can be direct and blunt and in somebody's face. I don't know that I can see you necessarily.
I wouldn't pursue.
Okay.
I definitely wouldn't pursue. I'm with you, Candace. I feel like, of course, if someone is interested, just making myself available, letting them know and a certain type of way that
how?
I'm interested as
well. What type of way? Help us sister
that
out.
Is a good question.
I don't know.
Question. I don't know. It could be with a look. It could be with
give me the
just
look.
Be
come on. Give me the look. Like just look like I'm a dude. Like I'll be like okay, so it's like your eyes went down a little bit. You had a little bit of a
come hither look. But yeah, I definitely wouldn't be able to pursue. But your situation, you probably would have said the same thing. I'm not going to pursue. But with your situation, you saw the struggle there and it was a safe place for you to move forward like that. Totally. So
it was a meeting in the middle. I wouldn't say that I was the one to initiate. He was the one to initiate. But once I saw that there was a little bit of like oh, I didn't realize what I did. You know, mm-hmm. like he, I got to a point where he was like, I'm interested, but I didn't realize I had to dive the full way in, you know? And that's where it was a meeting in the middle.
I see. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Christian, have you ever pursued a man?
Yeah. Yes.
How did that go?
You know, sometimes great, sometimes crash and burn. There's a mixture. But I found for me, in the situations where I pursued, somehow then, and I'm a very bold personality as well. I can very much take a room and just be like, okay, let's go. And so in those situations when I started the leading of the relationship, somehow I continued to be the leader of the relationship.
Be open. Don't be so closed. Don't be so strong as a single woman, you know, that you've got it. You've got your life. I mean, Mandisa, this could totally be you. Mm-hmm. Mandisa, you're a CEO of your company. You're, you know, out in front of millions of people. And it could be perceived by some men that see she's so strong. Yeah. She doesn't have need for a guy. Women, you need to know that at the heart of every man is a boy who wrapped a towel around his neck and pretended to be Superman. You know, we want to be Superman. We want to show up and save the day. We want to feel like a hero. And if you are so strong and you're killing it, which is super attractive, but you're closed off, like you got it, you won't get past, because there's so many people to look at. We'll go, she's good, she's not looking.
How do we show you that I'm, I got it together, but I'm also open?
Well, first have it together. Okay. That's the biggest thing. Like, you know, a strong man will pursue a strong woman, and that's a good thing.
Ooh, safe. Yeah.
Slow it down.
I'm gonna tell you right now, what you just said is so good. Yeah. A strong man will pursue a woman.
A strong woman.
And a strong woman will not pursue a man.
Okay, that's really what I want to ask about that.
That is true.
Yeah, it is.
For you, it is.
Do not pursue me.
So yeah, tell me what that means. What does that look like for a woman to pursue you that's like, nah?
Don't ask me on no date. Don't be coming after me. No, show that you're interested.
How do we show we're interested?
Wow. I mean, if we're friends, you'll be able to know how to deliver that message.
We don't.
What?
I promise you, we don't know what you consider to be
us. But if you're truly friends,
know.
Because I think oftentimes what we do is I see her, I holler. No, me, I build a friendship to kind of get to know her spirit. Then when I get to know her spirit, if I like her spirit, then I pursue and I say that. I think oftentimes lady be like, he looks good. Hey, we should go out sometime.
That's a no-no for you.
That's a turnoff for
me. Is that for everybody else? Is that a turnoff for y'all?
Yeah. My man said no.
I don't really mind a girl like letting me know like they're interested, but I think there's like a way that they can like kind of lay it out there, but not be like, hey, you need to take me out of space. Like
what's
if you come at me like that, I'm be like, right, are you paying? Like, no, I think there's a way to do it that is like respectful.
Tell us the way. What does it look like? A girl comes up to you.
But it's different per every man.
Asking you.
I think it depends like on the relationship. Like if I'm really good friends with a girl.
Yes.
And she's like, you know, we've been hanging out. Like we should really take some time. Like just us, like me and you should spend some time together. I think saying it on that note is like way better than you need to take me on a date. Cause then I feel like the expectation is you want a free meal. Like you want somebody just to open the door for you. You want more of just a placeholder. I'm going on a date tonight. Then I want to build a relationship with you.
Interesting.
And I think if it's really good, then I would feel better.
But the Bible says that he who finds a woman, his wife, finds his great thing. And he said earlier, be going after your dreams. Yeah. If you're in the sea, you're swimming somewhere. Let me pursue you while you're swimming to your destination, while you're going after your purpose. Mm-hmm. If you turn around and swim towards me, it lets me know that now you're not really focused on God and your purpose. Mm-mm. You're focused on finding a man.
Yeah.
And I can't find you if you just put it all in front of me.
You know, I did his single panel a couple of weeks ago.
I would like to answer your initial question.
Yeah.
As somebody who I've been told can be intimidating, I think I will probably have to pursue on a certain level because, first of all, men aren't pursuing me, and that could be for a lot of reasons, but I've been told that for a man to feel comfortable in pursuing me, that he would want me to say something. And so I don't know what pursuit looks like necessarily, but I think that I'm going to be forced to actually let somebody know, hey, I'm interested in you, without sounding like a dork and saying, hey, I'm interested in you. So,
but is that pursuit?
I don't know.
Deep down inside, guys want to be pursued too.
Exactly.
No.
Whoa.
Who? No.
Speak for yourself. I won't necessarily say that guys want to be pursued.
I don't want to
know,
bro.
No, I know where you're going with this.
I just want you to not throw subliminals my way.
Exactly.
All the time. Like, you're going to throw hints. Yeah. Throw something direct. Let me know.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
Give an example of what that looks like, because we don't know.
Okay, so a lot. Okay, that's pursuit.
That's not pursuit.
It is.
Pursuing is you're coming for me. He's saying, yo, she's saying, and correct me if I'm wrong, she says, yo, you're handsome. I would love to get to know you a little bit more. That's right. Clear.
That's not too forward?
That's not
pursuit to you?
That's not pursuit.
Really?
Because once you do that, you leave it up to me to pursue.
Make the plan. Exactly.
She opened the door. No. She initiated the interaction.
She didn't open the door, bro. She just unlocked it.
Exactly.
I'm going to open the door.
So
and
now
walk
what
through.
I do with that information is up to me.
Exactly.
I don't have to pursue her after that.
But if I choose to do that, now
I can court her if I choose to.
So in that situation, you're saying that is a good thing for a woman to do.
Absolutely.
Y'all. That doesn't feel fine. Well,
If you come after me, I'm not going to feel like a man. Like, because I was created to hunt. You know,
that's
biblically.
What does coming after someone look like?
Yeah. What do you mean?
Conversation of, you're handsome, I'd like to get to know you. Do the version of that that's pursued.
Yes.
Cool, great. In my DM. So, hey, when can we go on that date?
Okay. So actually making the plan.
Like, yeah, she's doing all of the talking, trying to initiate it. Right. And I'm like, y'all, or not responding.
Yes. Showing interest and pursuing
is different.
It's two totally different
things. I think
things.
It's defining what do you say pursuing? If a woman asked you out, is that a no-no for you? Or is that kind of like, I kind of like it that she just put it out there?
I think it depends on the woman. In most cases, I'm probably not going to go down that route.
Me too.
If she's like, hey, you need to take me on a date, or if
not,
she's
hey,
like,
you need to take me on a date. What if she says, hey, I'm having a good time with you. Would you ever want to go out on a date?
Oh, if she say it like that, no, I'm
would you have a problem with that?
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, why is it
not
so
pursuing,
different?
Though,
but to me, that is pursuing.
How?
Because I'm asking you out.
Oh, then we're just defining it differently.
That's what I'm saying.
We're defining that differently, because pursuit to me means that I won't stop, that I'm still going.
Pursuit is to me. For me, asking a man out would be very, very difficult. But I've been told that I'm probably going to have to, because men will be intimidated to ask me out. So that's what I'm wondering is, was that pursuing, or is that just me kind of putting it out there because he won't?
If you are friends with this girl that you've been wanting to get to know, and she fine as all get out and everything like that, and she's like, hey, we be cracking up. We need to go out to Jay Alexander or something. And it'd be like, yep, we sure do need to go out to Jay Alexander.
That's okay for you.
If he was attracted to her.
If I was attracted to her.
But I mean, it's, you know, men, we used to it. This is how we came up. You shoot, you get turned down. You shoot, you get turned down.
Your personality, it's a lot like mine, and I know Bernie's, and a
Jesus,
lot of people,
otherwise known
as, I've heard you say that of Bernie, and I think people will describe him as sweet, like just kind and so compassionate, and I think, I mean, when I think of you, maybe the first word that I think of is strong, and powerful, and you make stuff happen, and so in your relationship together, who pursued who, and what did that look like?
Well, it's funny because you bring up that word pursued, because I feel like at least in church circles, there is this idea that a woman is never supposed to pursue a man.
Oh, we had a great discussion about that earlier today.
I think that like we've been doing a really total disservice in saying that a woman is never, because some men, by their personality, they actually need help. They're just gonna sit there, and Bernie was actually one of those. He is so non-aggressive. He's a peacemaker and a peacekeeper. Mm-hmm. And so just by nature, he's just never going to put himself out there. Mm-hmm. So by pursuing, do I mean that you're supposed to like, I think it's because we get confused with what the world thinks of as pursuing. So I don't mean you know, put on less clothing,
right, and
put yourself in front of him so you can make him stumble.
Yeah.
But I did have to pursue the friendship.
How? And
so when we first met, it was back in 1997, and I was getting my very first record deal, and I had to do a showcase. Yeah. You would know what that is, yeah, right? And I didn't know any players, and Gabe Patillo's mom, Jackie, said, I know this guy, you should hire him as a piano player. And so I hired Bernie, and that's how we met.
Awesome.
And for me, it was that instant. I saw him, and I was like, please, oh, please, oh, please be a good person, because he was so cute. And then he started playing, and I was like, oh, Jesus, please. Please let him.
Please let him. Amazing piano player, y'all. Like, brilliant.
And then he was super broken. He had just come out of a broken engagement. It was a month before they were supposed to get married. He found out she was living a double life. So he was heartbroken, and he was telling me all about it. And then I was like, I can fix you. Like, I can put this all back together. I'll take all those pieces and glue them for you. And so for me, it was a matter of, I had to come up with reasons why we needed to see each other.
Wow.
So I wasn't a songwriter at that point in my life, but I was for him. I was like, do you want to write a song? And we're like, write? He was like, sure. And then I was like, so you're a writer, so if you ever need somebody to do demos, because I was a demo singer back then. And so he hired me to, so we would just find, I would find reasons.
Okay.
Because if I waited for him, and then I would find out things about him, and it'd be like, okay, I'm going to create opportunities for our friendship. And so if I would have waited, he would never have called.
You don't think so? Would he say that?
I think he would say that.
To bring it all home.
Bring it home, Chance.
I mean, all of this is, every guy is different.
Yeah.
Every situation is different. But what we don't tell you, and this is why we're here, right?
Mm-hmm.
To tell you what we don't tell you. I think in general, you'll find some guys who love women who just roll over and you're just here to, you know, fulfill my every wish. And there's some women out there and some men like that, and they live happily ever after. Mm-hmm. I don't want any part of that, you know? Then you have another guy out there who's like looking for a woman who's going somewhere, and he wants to see your strength. He wants to see your passion and your fire. And that's super attractive, but you also have to be soft. There has to be a softness and an openness. That's what these guys are saying. If you're too direct, it's off-putting. But if you're open and soft and, like, you know, find a way to be feminine and to be open, to let people know that you're interested without being super direct, you know, then we get to put on our cape and come over and swoop you up. Fly off into the sunset.
Oh, that's
fantastic.
Yeah. Superman finds Superwoman. That's what I'm talking about.
Come on, dude.
Technically, yes, Superman found Lois Lane, but sorry, I digress.
I love that.
That was a day, wasn't it? It's so interesting hearing the different perspectives of all of my friends. And for me, it was also interesting because there was a lot of differences in how people thought that it should be done. You know, Elizabeth had one perspective and Anthony had another and Natalie had another, and everybody just kind of thinks differently. And so I guess I walk away saying, it's probably not going to be one cookie cutter way that this whole pursuing thing is done. It feels to me like every situation is going to be different. And so as you think about how to pursue and if you should pursue, I want you to give yourself a little bit of grace, and I want you to follow the lead of the Holy Spirit. Speaking of the Holy Spirit, as you've heard everybody's opinion, I always want to bring it back to the truth of who matters the most. And when we think about this whole issue of pursuing or being pursued, I think about how, yes, I long to have a man here on earth pursue me, but I do know what it feels like to be pursued. My favorite psalm is Psalm 139. And in verse 7, it says, "Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, or if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me. Your right hand will hold me fast." There is nowhere that I can go apart from God. He chases after me. What can separate me from the love of Jesus?
you know, I recorded a song on my Overcomer album called The Distance, and it talks about how God pursues us. His love is relentless. He chases after us. And so if you were like me and maybe you long to feel pursued, I want you to feel the pursuit of your Heavenly Father. He loves you unconditionally, and He chases hard after you. Be sure that you subscribe and also hit that little notification bell so that you'll be the first to know when we upload new episodes every Wednesday. We'll see you next week.